great, this is such a good question that it needs time to be thought about. But it would definitely have to do with
toilet
some kind of hygiene. Yeah, I was just going to say that.
Disruptors have assembled.
Oh, I'm so excited. It's Terry Hitchcock from Harkins Theaters. I've seen this film now twice on a big screen, and I cannot wait for people to see this at a Harkins. Congratulations on this.
Thanks so much, Terry.
Thanks for having us.
Benoit Blanc, the detective?
Mr. Blanc, I cannot overstate my gratitude to be here.
I love how we first see Benoit Blanc. He's going through a little bit of a funk, and I think a lot of us can relate. But it reminded me, I actually share something in common with him. I, too, love a great bath. And I'm curious, what is the thing that you share in common with him the most, would you say, Daniel Craig?
His love of cravats. I don't know. I don't know. He's me. I'm him. I don't know. I mean, Ryan created this amazing character for me to play. And it's just a joy and just to sort of mess, you know, to play around with and to, you know, what I like about him mostly is I like his mystery. I think the fact that the less we know about him, the better. But he's going through a few. He's not having the best of times at the beginning of the film, but it all changes.
I've invited you all to my island.
Hi!
Because tonight, a murder will be committed. My murder.
Once you're dead, will we still be able to talk to you?
Yeah, I'm not playing dead the whole weekend, dude.
Ryan, I love everybody gets an entrance, in some cases more than one. We meet the characters initially, that dock, you know, when everybody shows up on the dock. Out of all the entrances, did you have a favorite?
Oh my God. I mean, I quite like Kate Hudson's entrance, who plays Birdie. She kind of has a very Fellini-esque riding in, hello! And she has an insane mask on. And it's
the back of the...
On the back of like the cart. Part of the inspiration, one of several points of entry for me for inspiration for these movies were those star-studded mysteries that I grew up watching back in the late 70s, early 80s when I was a kid. And the notion of these being kind of all-star cast affairs, when you're writing, you want to give everybody a grand entrance onto the stage. It's kind of part of the fun of it.
Another great joy was when we finally get to Miles' place, he's just got a compound filled with the most ridiculous of things. I know that each of you can afford some nice stuff. So I'm just curious, in your house, is there something, Daniel, I'll start with you on this, that is kind of a guilty pleasure and friends might show up and go, seriously, you have this?
Let me think. I don't think there's anything... I mean, I think there's a lot of kind of things that I'm very lucky and grateful to have, but I don't think there's one thing that it's not kind of the way I was brought up, really. I don't have that kind of, I'm trying to think of this one thing that kind of, I have a nice car, which I love, but I'm also slightly embarrassed about. So it's complicated. Complicated relationship I have.
I understand. Well, get over it, because you deserve a nice car, at least one.
Oh, yeah, so. Right, thank you.
Good advice.
Claire, you look so cute.
Harkins Theaters, which is the largest family-owned theater chain in the U.S. And for at least a week, we get to see
it
as well.
Yes, we want people in the theater.
Well, let me just say, I just mentioned this is my second time seeing it, and I want to encourage people to see it twice because when you know what's going on, you can go back and look for all of those cool things.
Yeah.
Did you all do the same thing? Have you seen it more than once?
Third time. And so fun.
And still saw something.
Yes.
You know, I still was like, oh, because my eye, you know, sign of a great filmmaker, your eye is over here. And then there's always something going on in Ryan's frame. And so I definitely saw some more things last night on the third go.
For sure. How many times have you guys seen it?
I've seen it maybe four times. I know.
Do you catch new things each time?
This time, I caught at least five different things that I did not see the first time, second time, or third time.
This was my second time. Last night was my second time with a big audience. And I was seeing all kinds of great stuff that I... And we were there. It was very strange.
You made the movie, so
but I think that's just the magic of Ryan. The editing, the just thinking back about character development and just even the little Easter eggs that Ryan and I talked about. I'm sure you and Ryan talked about planting some things that when people go back and see the second and third time, they're going to be like, it was there all along.
The characters each, some of them have more than one great entrance. You know, we're introduced to them a few times. When you sat back and watched everybody's entrances, pick your favorite entrance out of all your castmates.
Oh my goodness. There were some good ones. I mean, Kate
in Birdie, the, Kate Birdie in the J. Buggy.
Yes.
Kate in the buggy.
Oh my God, with the mask. With the mask. We can't give away too much.
No, right, right.
The mask, that was good.
I think Blanc walking up to the pool in that, in his striped pajama bathing suit.
Oh my goodness.
First of all, what was that, by the way? I've never seen anybody really wear that.
People are going to be so, like, first of all, Jenny Egan, we have to give a shout out to
the costumes. The costumes are probably the best joke in the movie.
Because they do so much for us, but we don't even have to say anything, and our looks will just give you so much about the character that we're playing.
Yeah, let's just say, if your Thanksgiving wants to include Dave Bautista in a crocodile bikini, this is the film for you.
I was going to say, also, Mile, when we first meet Edward Norton's character on the beach, is also a pretty fabulous introduction.
Let's just say he's very musical, and there's some other really cool things about that entire scene.
Yeah, your exchange is pretty brilliant.
the other thing that people need to, I mean, there's so many things people need to look out for and pay attention to. It's the products that are endorsed by various celebrities that we know. And I'm curious, for each of you, if you could pick a product that Kate Hudson, I know you actually have Fabletics and a lot of things, but what would be a great product and vice versa?
Oh,
Bloom.
Yeah, there are so many.
This is such a good question that it needs time to be thought about. But it would definitely have to do with toilet some kind of hygiene. Yeah, I was just going to say that. Yeah. Definitely like something in the hygiene department, like toothpaste.
Yeah.
Or like something that is like
just
a random.
Just my face on it.
Just
though.
Your.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. Like smiling. Just like a shiny toothpaste.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like a tube.
A tube.
Elongated.
Yeah.
Or like your own
floss line. I feel like that is a.
There's got to be one that's better for me other than the ones that I actually do have, right?
Right. But I mean, do you need to see my face on your floss every morning?
Yes. Maybe.
In other words, she's trying to get you to come up with a different answer for her.
Yeah.
Besides the shake.
Oh, it's so funny.
Floss.
All right.
Just like Han floss.
Like, what would Daniel's be?
Oh. I think he's got to be cravats.
Yeah.
But nice ones, like handkerchiefs. Like he could, for real though, he could.
Just
do this.
The neck.
I'm making,
though.
Like, you know, yeah, light
like,
of
you're
my
like
products,
really, right. You're really branding right now. You're like, you're like at the branding department at CAA right now.
Yeah, right now I was like Daniel's right. He's got to get into the pocket
handkerchiefs.
Probably like an electric BMW M50, right? Like,
him trying to steer me. No, Altoids.
What? Oh, what? You're the one who likes the hot sauce.
I know. I just told him. I said, listen, I just had a lot of salsa, so please, you know, be kind. Yeah. Edward, you have that.
The irony is I can't give it away, but there is Janelle's character interacts with. A hot sauce endorsed by a certain colleague of ours. But the irony is, like, Janelle wouldn't even flinch in reality. She could take hot sauce in the eyes, ears, and nose, and she'd be like,
own blood? Is my blood hot sauce? That's the question that we should ask.
That's one of the scenes that made the entire audience. That's like,
yes,
oh,
it is great.
No.
I said that last night. There's just a certain thing that Ryan did that gets it's like in Misery when Kathy Bates breaks James Caan's ankles, right? Is that kind of an audience reaction?
That intense?
Janelle Monáe said Altoids for Ed Norton.
Shade. Shade. Janelle, respect.
Yeah.
I feel like...
Okay. Sorry, I know you're like, get this woman out of
here. You really got us going.
But feel free to keep rolling on this.
Okay, you really got us going.
Let it all out.
Hell yeah!
This is reckless. Killer wouldn't hesitate to kill again if it covers their tracks.